Oh, I should be running. Oh, I should be running. When you call me. close and open. March, march. Bring it down to the roll. If I move back, is he still near me? Otherwise, my head's cut off.
Squat.
remember April out. Back. here. Bend more. So lock your knees. Okay. Okay. Lock your knees.
Thumbs up. Okay, so.
Welcome together.
Yeah.
one knee. Big shoulder roll. Back right into our bicep curls. I'm taking my legs in a little bit closer. Get a little forward.
Woo! Two more.
Woo! Make sure you're breathing.
Woo! Another body I don't wanna be in, and I don't ever wear.
Awesome. Okay. How you doing? Everybody okay?
I'm gonna unmute myself.
Huh?
I unmuted myself.
Okay. I thought you said I shot myself.
Well, I'm standing here, aren't I?
Yes, you are. So, Mary Jane, is Anne out playing with the pool boy?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Well, a quickie. Oh my, we're getting to look at Anne totally different from now on.
Yeah, well.
Okay. Hamstring stretch.
Can't see you.
You can't see me?
Well, I can see you from the waist up.
Well, do you need to see my feet?
We don't need to.
I want you to hear my jokes.
Yeah, so you're fine.
Emergency department via ambulance with burns on his lower extremities. His shoes are charred and the bottoms of his pants are definitely burned away, but his skin isn't so bad. He'd been trying to use a propane power weed burner in his yard, think flamethrower, and things got a little out of control. I smelled alcohol on his breath, so I asked the guy if he'd been drinking. And he looked me directly in the eye and said, no. I got drunk just standing next to him. It was a once-in-a-lifetime setup, and I couldn't help myself. As straight-faced as professionally as possible, I said, sir, liar, liar, pants on fire. The paramedics all turned at once and ran out of the
room. Oh, I knew that.
All right, the patient just stared at me. He was so drunk, I went totally over his head. This is a true story. That was pretty good.
Okay.
You say so.
Okay, flex and point, flex and point.
You want a Coke?
No.
What? Okay. Pushing out on your inner knee, keeping your head above your heart. Inner thigh stretch. Go ahead and let one arm dangle. Relax, relax, relax. Okay, other arm, same thing. Keep your head above your heart. Okay, so a blonde enters a store that sells curtains. Blonde goes into a store that sells curtains. She tells the salesman, I would like to buy a pair of pink curtains. The salesman assures her that they have a large selection of pink curtains. He shows her several patterns, but the blonde seems to have a hard time choosing. Finally, she selects a lovely pink floral print.
The salesman then asks what size curtain she needs. The blonde promptly replies, 50 inches. 15 inches, asks the salesman. That sounds very small. What room are they for? The blonde tells him they aren't for a room, but they're for her computer monitor. The surprised salesman replies, but miss, computers don't need curtains. The blonde says, hello, I've got windows.
Oh. That is a blonde one.
Yes, it is. Okay. Take it, push and pull. And let's go around to the other side. Same thing, walk that leg back, outside leg comes up, outside leg, outside arm comes up, and forward, pull it back. Okay. Oh. Big stretch. Okay, pull and push. All right, let's come back. Walkie, 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 walkie. Up we go. Two blondes living in Oklahoma were sitting on a bench talking, and one blonde says to the other, which do you think is further away, Florida or the moon? The other blonde turns and says, hello, can you see Florida?
It's like Russia.
Hinging a little bit. Okay, other side. Okay, so a blonde lady motorist was about 2 hours from San Diego when she was flagged down by a man whose truck had broken down. The man walked up to the car and asked, are you going to San Diego? Sure, answered the blonde, do you need a lift? Not for me, I'll be spending the next 3 hours fixing my truck. My problem is I've got two chimpanzees in the back which have to be taken to the San Diego Zoo. They're a bit stressed already, so I don't want to keep them out on the road all day. Shoulder roll. Could you possibly take them to the zoo for me? I'll give you $100 for your trouble. $200 for your trouble. $100 for your trouble. It's gonna give me some money. I'd be happy to, said the blonde. So the two chimpanzees were ushered into the back seat of the blonde's car and carefully strapped into their seatbelts. Off they went. With his 5 hours later, the truck driver was driving through the heart of San Diego when suddenly he was horrified. There was the blonde walking down the street and holding hands with the two chimps, much to the amusement of the big crowd. With a screech of his brakes, he pulled off the road and ran over to the blonde. What in the world are you doing here? He demanded. I gave you $100 to take these chimpanzees to the zoo. Well, I know you did, said the blonde. We had money left over, so now we're going to SeaWorld. Push it down.
Oh.
Give you a break from the puns, you guys. Up, up, up. Lift, lift, lift. And then push it down. All the way up to the back of the chair. And you. Okay, shoulder roll. Ear to shoulder. Slowly turn your head. Take it a little bit further back. Shoulders are back and down. Tummies are tight. Drop your chin to your chest. Come back around to center. Up we go. Other ear, other shoulder. Slowly turn. Drop your chin to your chest. Come back around to center. Look up. Kiss. And you guys are done for the day.